Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we have seen how this webpack is running, how webpack is loading the dependencies. So this was the project and we have written simple hello world app on the nothing else. Okay, and here we are bootstrapping our component. Now we are sending this bootstrap file main.ts to the webpack. Webpack is an entry point, output point, and we are doing some processing with the help of module loaders. So we are using two module loader, TypeScript loader and style loader. Okay, so let's run this code. So this is the second one. First one we have seen with the system.js. This is with the webpack. So we can just do npm run start. So it will execute webpack dev server and will launch our application on port 3000. So indirectly we are using webpack dev server. So if you see npm run start, what it is doing, there is a task defined in the package.json. npm run start will execute npm run server. Npm run server is indirectly doing webpack dev server. So there are two things. There is a webpack, so you can also create another task which is a build. So build is actually responsible for only creating build. Okay, so like if you are hitting npm run build, so it will execute the webpack command which will just generate the output build, right? So you can see the output bundle.js build has been generated. So that is the webpack build. And if you wanted to just execute the server only, npm run, just make npm run server. So it will execute this command, webpack dev server. So that is the difference between webpack and webpack dev server. Webpack dev server is actually launching your application on some local server after building it, after creating a bundle file. Webpack is just generating the bundle file, it is not launching your file. So you can see your bundle.js has been generated and your application is hosted on localhost 3000. So after launching this application, we would be able to see, like if I do so you can see I got the output, right? My application server is running and I got the hello world. So instead of this hello world, my component will be rendered. I will get the hello world on the UI. You can see the output on the browser also, right? This is coming from that component. Okay, that's all. Thank you.